When this happens, apartments are flooded. You know, landlords have very difficult time. Houses, like streets, parking, everywhere, just mess. And that shows, you know, how much this community is close. And they are very expressive, crying, wailing. The emotion is very, very clear. And neighbors could be disturbed, you know. So in Canadian perspective, they might call a police, you know. But this is the situation of the community. So from the first day, people start to gather, and then they will take over the kitchen, everything. If you lose someone close of your family, you are not expected to cook or to do anything. People come with food, with drink, and serve everyone in the house. So maybe for a couple of weeks, for a month even, it goes like that. So from the first day, maybe to about a month, there are always people in the house. They sleep in the house. Might be one bed, but they bring mattress or carpet in the floor, and all of them, ladies together, men together, spend together. And sometimes, you know, they do dramas, you know, they very invent some kind of actor, like they act some kind of story, just to take away the mind of the grieving person, just to make him laugh for a while, to take away his focus from the emotional grief that he is entangled with. So these are the community, the cultural community that we do. So back home, they put a tent, a big tent, maybe 400 people, that will be for 2 or 3 weeks. And people are coming morning, evening, during the day, in the night, from everywhere, from very, very far, from the provinces even could come to pay their respect to the family. So that gives a great comfort. And even though we live in Canada, it's the same thing here too.